Ta-da! Bonjour!
Today, we're talking about wireless video transmitting.
And if it's all the rage or if it's just a little bit of overkill on your next production. I talk about the pros, cons, and the pros of it being a pro piece of gear, and the things I like about it, and more importantly, the things I dislike about it.
For those of you who have watched the behind the scenes of a Hollywood movie, chances are you've seen the director or the cinematographer or a crew member standing behind a monitor while the shooter, the camera operator, shoots the scene. This is done by using wireless video transmission. Now, essentially, it's kind of like using a wireless adapter for, let's say, your lav mics, only it wirelessly transmits the video signal so that you can watch the film without actually being behind the camera. Now, this is a really great luxury that a lot of directors use so that they're not hovering over their cinematographer's shoulder. Sometimes this is used by getting just a really long HDMI. In most cases, it's used by using a wireless video transmitter. And the transmitter I'm gonna be talking about in this video is the Hollyland, what is it called? The Hollyland Mars 400S, this guy. And my thoughts and opinions using it, but more importantly, just using wireless video. Personally, I've used them on a ton of film sets, mostly because if I have a cinematographer shooting the film or a camera operator, I'm not breathing over their shoulder or trying to look at the tiny monitor that they're looking at, and you're not fighting for the monitor. This can get very overwhelming, especially let's say you're doing a chase scene where a character is running somewhere. You don't wanna be running behind the cinematographer doing this deal, which happens all the time on independent productions that don't have a wireless video. So having that little monitor there so you don't have to chase behind your DOP, you can just sit there, Video Village, and actually watch the movie as if you're an audience member. What I've found is if I'm shooting a movie and I'm holding the camera, I'm with the camera, I'm viewing the experience as if I am the camera operator as opposed to an audience member. You're moving with the camera, you're going with all those grooves, and therefore you might be actually missing the key ingredients and secret ingredients to make a great scene. For example, you might be less focused on performance and more focused on, did the camera angle get it right? Are you out of breath after chasing the DOP? So having wireless video is a blessing more times than not. It also just looks really cool that you just can walk around with your monitor. It is like half ego boost, half like a real amazing charm. But you're like, Zach, we don't wanna hear about the pros. We all know about the pros of the pro gear. Let's hear about the cons of the pro gear. The cons of this gear is the fact that wireless video transmission, which I've said so many times throughout this video, the biggest con of all of it is the fact that if you're getting more cost-effective or affordable gear, sometimes you're going to be dealing with lack of, let's say, quality or transmission signal, or just have more room for error. The reason why expensive camera gear is so expensive is because you have a smaller window of error. The cheaper the piece of gear is, the larger the window of error is. You might get like a fuzzy signal, you might not get the most HD view, you might not get the most perfect thing the first time. This is something to be aware of all pieces of equipment. If you get a cheap light, you're not gonna get the perfect experience using it. It's the same as if you buy a cheap car, you're not gonna get the perfect drive. It'll get you from A to B, but it's not gonna be the best drive ever. So the Hollyland Mars 400 is, it does the job, it's great. But some of the technical errors that I got while using it were sometimes if I like set the monitor down or I like accidentally touched it a certain way, my transmission signal would just cut out and I'd get a black screen, which really isn't the greatest when you have talent waiting there for you to film the scene. I found this happened to me a few times, so I was like delicately holding the monitor, which is not something that belongs on a film set. If you have to hold a piece of gear with delicacy as if it's like a porcelain glass camera, it's not going to really fit well on a film set where things are being lugged around or you're chasing after the cinematographer. You want your monitor to be as robust as, let's say, the camera you're shooting on. And chances are, if you're shooting on any sort of camera, it can handle wear and tear and a little bit of throwing around. I'm not suggesting you do that, but I think you get my point. So when it came to the signal and things cutting out, like any sort of wireless technology, these are things that you're going to face. The nice thing is if you have hard-lined HDMI plugged right into your camera, you know exactly where that signal is going through, and if there's an error, you can tell that it's the HDMI cord or it's the port into the camera. Where you start opening up that room for error is the fact that you're dealing with frequencies, channels, and things that we can't even see. That's why audio for me is always something that just like freaks me out a lot because it's like, I don't understand waveforms. I can't see waveforms as much as I can see visuals. So I like step away from it. This isn't just this transmitter's issue. I've dealt with this with a lot of other lower end transmitters. On the higher end, something like a Teradek, I've experienced this a lot less, but that's just because that's sort of like the Porsche or the Lamborghini of these devices. And so therefore, like I said, you have a smaller window of error. Another major error that this had, now this isn't actually the fault of the transmitter or the Hollyland product, this was a fault of Sony, is when you switch the camera over into 4K mode, we weren't getting a signal on the camera. So when my cinematographer, Carl, was shooting on our gimbal, and I wanted to see the image he was filming, he wasn't getting anything on his screen, but I was getting it on the monitor. So therefore, you had to sacrifice one screen for the other. So therefore, I had to disable my screen so he could actually operate properly. Now again, this isn't an error of the transmitter, and this actually may have just been lack of knowledge on our end, but at the end of the day, when the going gets tough and you're going through these technical errors on set, where you can't see anything on the screen, but your other thing can, it just, again, it's that window of error is much larger at this point. And that's just the window of error when it comes to using less professional grade tech. Now, if we were shooting on, let's say, something like an Arri Alexa with a Teradek transmitter, of course, we're probably gonna get that efficiency that we paid for. So just remember, whenever you're using more cost-effective gear, you're not gonna get that speedy efficiency as if you were on the higher ends of pieces of gear. That being said, that's just the negative. I actually think there's a lot more positive about this than the negative. The fact that this transmitting system revolves around the $500 mark, give or take, is a really great price for what you get. Not only do you get a transmitter that you can attach directly to your camera and start using basically as soon as you unbox it, but another amazing thing is it comes with an app. So therefore, now not only do you have your wireless monitor that you can use, but you can actually transmit the signal to your cell phone, which has been a thing that I have fantasized about. So maybe fantasized isn't the right word. It is a thing that I really thought about. Now I don't even know what the right word is. It is a thing that I fantasized about for a very long time being a shooter. I always thought like, man, I've got this screen that I carry around in my pocket all the time. And the only time that I can get a signal from my Sony to this is by using the crappy like Sony Play Memories app that's like delayed and puts my camera in a weird mode. It just doesn't work that well. So having this made my cell phone a screen that transmitted a high quality signal, a high quality video that I could actually use for filming. It wasn't as high of a quality on my cell phone as it was on my screen, but that being said, you don't need an additional monitor. You can just get the Mars 400 and then transmit the signal to your cell phone and use that as your screen if you don't have an additional monitor. Okay, I'm going to interrupt this section with a little bit of overview that I got from the team at Hollyland. They saw the video that I made, my first cut, and they addressed some of my concerns. The first one was the fact that if you are looking for a more advanced version of the Hollyland Mars 400, they actually have the Cosmos series, which goes from 600 to 1000. And those are all sort of their more advanced professional style monitors that they have out there. So the whole connection issue and any sort of disabling through distance, this actually alleviates that problem. And the Mars 400 is a little bit more of the beginner level for the monitor system. Now, again, from a sort of YouTuber filmmaker's perspective, is a monitor really a good investment? I don't really think so. I think there's many other things that you can get. And by monitor, I mean wireless monitor. I do think actually having a real monitor is super valuable. That being said, if you start going into shooting short films and collaborating with cinematographers and other, you know, you're working with clients, having wireless video is crucial and super a necessity. And if you don't want to break the bank by getting one of these things, you guys can look at the Mars 400. It is super affordable for what you get out of it. I've been using it consistently on client shoots that I've been doing and short films I've been doing in my backyard. So that's a little bit of the disclaimer and description of doing these things. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for tuning in. Again, if you guys are interested in this product, you can look at it in the description below. But I'm sweating my face off up here. It's super hot. So I'll see you guys later. Keep making some great stuff. I'm gonna finish this gum. Bye.